They are two of the most skilled paired skaters in the world. Eric Radford and Meagan Duhamel are two-time world champions and they recently won bronze and gold at the Winter Olympics. Eric and Meagan are currently in the country and they join us now. Well, hello to you both. You're from Canada. Is ice skating something that's in the Canadian DNA?
I think so. I think that every child in Canada learns to skate in the same way that they learn to walk. And in the same way that, you know, in some countries, maybe they focus on swimming or skiing. But in Canada, skating is truly part of our DNA.
So the list of your awards seems absolutely endless. And hearty congratulations. You've been skating together for 8 years. I'm guessing trust must be a fairly important part of your partnership.
Definitely. Trust and adaptability. You know, from day one, Meagan and I have always been on the same page. We worked really, really hard every single day. We went through our ups and downs, but we're always there for one another. And when we're learning new elements, you know, I have to trust that Megan's going to do her job and she trusts me in the same regard.
Now, I love this. You're a little bit of an odd couple. Meagan, you're 4'11" in the old money, or about 1.5 meters tall. And Eric, you're 6'2", but you seem a natural fit. Meagan, is it true your outfits are designed to make you look a bit taller?
Can you repeat that? Sorry.
Is it true some of your outfits are designed to make you look a little bit taller?
We try as much as we can, even with things like costume designs, things like trying to make my costumes make my body appear longer, and Eric's costumes to kind of like shrink him a little bit. And we are careful with some of our choreography and all these kind of moves, choreographical moves that we do, that we look a little bit more balanced.
Meagan, you also pack a punch. You once broke Eric's nose during a competition, is that right?
I didn't punch him in the face and break his nose. We missed the proper takeoff of our triple twist, so I didn't get the height I needed. So instead of finishing my rotation over his head, he was catching me and I was still finishing my rotation.
But it's actually something that's quite common for pair boys. A lot of pair boys in the world will have like slightly crooked nose because in practice, it does happen
when
the girl's
learning.
Elbow. Yeah, when you're learning that particular move, the twist where you throw the girl up and you have to catch her, there's a lot of times when you're learning it that the girl will knock your nose once or twice.
There you go, there's something we never knew. So broken noses aside, how punishing is skating on the body?
I mean, you know, we're in our 30s now. We definitely have aches and pains that will probably be with us for the rest of our lives. But, you know, we put a lot of work into injury prevention. It's actually probably been one of our main focuses in the last few years as we've, you know, gotten older in the sport. There's a lot of time on the ice. It is a lot of sort of repetitive impact, but it can be mitigated through, like, the proper exercise and the right plan off the ice.
And there are things that you kind of just learn to deal with. I have a permanent indent in my right hip from falling on throws. I always fall on a throw on the same spot, especially when we were learning the difficult throw quad. So my hip bone on my right side is just permanently like indented, and it will be for the rest of my life.
Wow.
And that's just, you know, that just comes with the game, and that's just the way it is.
Well, it seems to me it might be worth it when you take home, like you did at the recent Winter Olympics, gold and bronze. You skated to Adele's Hometown Glory. How much thought goes into the songs you choose, and what did that particular song mean to you?
I think when we're choosing our music for a season, we kind of like pile together a bunch of different ideas, and then we'll sit down with our choreographer, listen to a bunch and see what resonates with us.
And we actually started the season with a different long program. We started the season to music from Muse, which was really upbeat and a little bit more of a rock theme, which was really fun and really different than what all the other pair teams in the world do. But going into the Olympics, less than 2 months before the Olympics, we felt like we weren't connecting to that music as well as we wanted to. So we went back to this program of Adele that we won our second world title with. We felt more connected emotionally to this music, and it was easier for us to skate to.
Wow. And then you announced after the Olympics your retirement. So what's next?
Well, we're here. You know, we're teaching a seminar. We're going to be performing in the show tonight. We're really excited about that. We'll be heading to Perth tomorrow to continue this seminar and do another show there. We're going to be doing a tour in Japan, our Stars on Ice tour, and then we have a tour across Canada in May, which is the Stars on Ice tour of our country in Canada.
And then that takes us till the end of May. Our federation will have their annual general meeting where we will go to do presentations. And then in June, hopefully we'll be able to take some time off and take a little bit of a holiday, a longer holiday than we're used to, because usually in June we're getting back into our training to prepare for the upcoming season. But this year we won't have to do that. So we're looking forward to a longer break than normal in the summer.
You might even get time to see the odd movie. Tell me, have you seen I, Tonya?
Actually, we were invited to the premiere when it played for the first time in Montreal.
What did you think?
I really liked it. I thought it was really well done. I thought Margot Robbie was incredible. Allison Janney was so good as the mother. It was a little bit of, you know, dark humor, but this is a story that we grew up with when we were, like, just starting skating. So to see it kind of come to life in that way, I thought they did a really good job.
And it's really entertaining, but it's really important for people to know that this is not everybody's skating journey. The skating sport and skaters' experiences are very different. Tonya's story is very unique. Yes. And this is not such a common experience in skating. So we don't want to scare anybody away.
No. And people can hear about your skating experience if they go to these special events that you're here for in Australia. If you'd like to go, head to o'briengrouparena.com.au for tickets. And please thank Eric and Meagan. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.